The 5D4 is the all-round professional DSLR that's designed to perform in every situation. In this video, I'm going to take a closer look at the 5D4 so you can get to know your new camera. Let's get started. So we're going to start by taking you through a run-through of the basic buttons and features and the locations of those buttons and features on the 5D Mark IV. Moving to the left of camera now, you'll notice the on-off switch. To turn the camera on, simply turn the switch to the right to the on position. The camera will turn on. Above the on-off switch, you'll also notice the camera's main command dial. This dial is used to switch between the camera's different modes, remembering to hold the center button in first to rotate between those modes. Below the on-off switch, you'll also see the main menu button. This button is used to enter the camera's menu. A quick tour through the menu page will show you the different menus that are available in order to change functions and features of your camera. To the right of the menu button, you will notice the info button. The info button, when pressed, will cycle through different reviewing pages to show you basic camera information, from your aperture and shutter speed selection, ISO, focus point selection. Further pressing this button will cycle through to different settings such as your electronic level. This electronic level is quite handy when using in the field to get your shots and horizons straight. On top of the camera, you will notice the camera's hot shoe. This hot shoe is used to either attach a microphone or a speed light. Below the hot shoe, you will also notice the camera's diopter. The diopter is used to focus the camera's eyepiece to your own individual eyesight. To focus the diopter, just ensure that when focusing through the viewfinder, to turn the dial left or right until the information through the viewfinder becomes sharp. We now move on to the main camera's viewfinder. The viewfinder is used when looking through the camera to compose your shots. You will notice while looking through the viewfinder a variety of information that's available to you: your camera's light meter, shutter speed, and aperture. To the right of the viewfinder, you will also notice a start-stop button. This button is used to activate your live view. By simply pressing this button, it will activate live view, enabling you to see what the camera sees. Surrounding the live view button, you will also notice a sliding switch. This switch is used to change between either your stills mode or flipping across into video mode. Moving down the left-hand side of your camera, you will first notice your creative modes button. By pressing this button, you can cycle through a number of options that are available to you, choosing your picture styles menu. Picture styles are used to record different contrasts and levels of saturation to give an overall different feel to your photography. Picture styles available to you vary from an automatic picture style, standard, and portrait, for example, to change the look and feel of your images. Also, within the main menu of your creative mode button, you'll have other options available to you. You also can move across into either multiple exposure or HDR modes. Also, moving down the left-hand buttons in your camera, you will notice four different blue-coloured buttons. The blue colours represent a playback option within your camera. So the play button will obviously play back images that you've shot on your camera. The rate button, you can rate the images. You also have a magnify button, which helps you zoom into your images and explore to look for fine detail. The delete button, which enables you to play back an image, choose an image which you want to delete, scroll across to erase and hit set to delete your image. Moving on to the rear of camera now, you will also see a multi-directional pad. This pad is used to cycle through different modes on the camera. So either through your menu, by hitting the menu button, this button enables you to move up and down through your menu or aside the main menus. Below the multi-directional pad, you will also notice a cue button. By pressing this cue button, you can cycle through the different options on the back of your LCD to change a number of different settings. On the rear of camera, you will also notice a customized button. This button, out of the box, enables you to change through the many different focus patterns the camera has available to you. The main scroll wheel at the rear of your camera is used to change many different functions and modes. We'll go into more of this in the next video. Within the main scroll wheel, you also have a set button. This set button is used to select any of the different modes that you choose. Below the scroll wheel, you also have a lock button. The lock button disables the scroll from activating, preventing you from changing any unexpected settings. On top of your camera, you have the main shutter button. This is used to depress when taking pictures. Just below the shutter release, you will also see an M function button. This button is used to cycle between different autofocus modes. On top of the camera, you'll see four different buttons. To the left, you have the button here, which controls white balance, and the same button also controls different metering patterns. Okay, moving on to the drive button. When pressing the drive button and scrolling through the back wheel, you change the camera's drive modes. You also have the AF button. By pressing the AF button, you can change different AF modes from one shot AI servo, and AI focus. Here you have your exposure compensation button. By pressing this button and using the rear dial, you can change the exposure compensation of your camera. You also have your ISO button. By pressing the ISO button and using the top wheel, you can select your ISO. And lastly, you have the LCD light. By pressing the LCD light button, this will help illuminate the LCD in dark situations. When holding the camera, where your thumb naturally rests, you will notice three buttons. The first of the three buttons is your AF on button. By holding in this button, we'll activate autofocus. The center of the rear three buttons, you will also see your exposure lock button. By pressing this button, helps lock in a chosen exposure, noted by the asterisk on the rear LCD when this is active. The last of the three back buttons, you will notice an AF point selection button. By pressing this button, enables you to cycle through different autofocus patterns and to also move your autofocus point around your LCD. Moving on to the left-hand side of the camera, you'll notice a series of different rubber doors. Beneath each of the rubber doors, you will see different features. Firstly, you've got a flash sync or PC socket, your microphone and headphone input jack, and lastly, your HDMI and USB 3 port. So moving on to the front of camera, you have your depth of field preview button. By holding this button in, gives you a preview of the depth of field available to you in your shot. And on the opposite side, you will see a cable release socket. Simply lift the panel to expose the socket. You'll notice a button here on the left-hand side that if you depress, rotate the lens to release the lens. You'll notice on the lens mount of the camera itself a red dot, and on the top of the lens also a red dot. Simply connect the two red dots and rotate to attach the lens. On the underside of the camera, you'll notice the battery release door. Simply lift the latch, move the white tab to the side to release the battery. To reinstall the battery, simply install the battery, push it in until it clicks, and close the battery door. On the right-hand side of the camera grip, you'll notice the card door. To install the card, simply slide the door back to open, push down on the button to release the memory card, in this case, a compact flash. You'll also notice a slot for SD, which is spring-loaded. Simply push in on the card to release and push back in until the spring locks to reinstall the SD card. To place the compact flash card back into your camera, simply have the label facing the rear LCD screen, slide it into the slot with a full depression, then simply close the card door. You're ready to go. Make sure you check out the next video in our series, where we'll go into more in-depth features of the 5D Mark IV.